Here I am, just arrived from Bangkok with my piano at an elephant sanctuary in Kanchanaburi, Thailand. A cow wandered into the reception area, so I played him some music by my friend Kent Farbach, a piece that seems filled with sunlight. A tropical storm was threatening with a sudden strong wind, so we wrapped the piano for the night and retreated into our cabin. In the morning, we met up with a team of Thai filmmakers that had asked to come along on our trip to film the elephant's reaction to music. I put wheels on the piano to push it around the bumpy ground. Burkhan is the oldest elephant in the sanctuary, 72 years old or thereabouts. She doesn't have any teeth, and I wasn't sure about her hearing too. Our dog Sunday is well travelled and has met all sorts of animals on our adventures together. We loaded the piano in a truck to drive down to the river, something I was glad of, as pushing the piano in the hot sun in the hottest part of the year isn't that easy. There's a new elephant at the sanctuary called Ampan. She is one of the few lucky elephants to have had a good and caring owner that donated her to the sanctuary. She is calm, contented, and has a gentle temperament as a result. I then pushed the piano to a secluded place and spent a while playing under the shade of a tree. Marley strolled by and I played her Dustin O'Halloran's Opus 12 and Ravel's Pavane, which both have a slow, swaying theme. John, a four-year-old elephant, is the youngest elephant at the sanctuary. He's playful, extremely strong and heavy. A dangerous combination. And for our old friend Songkran, the Prelude, Fugue and Variation by Cesar Franck. Her bones look tired and skin thin from extreme old age, but this makes her all the more beautiful to me. At sunrise the next day, we all met up by the riverbank on the River Kwai, not far from the famous bridge. I wanted to play Romsai, a powerful bull elephant, some music by my French friend Maurice Dahl, who plays the musical saw. I Romsai was a must. This can make bull elephants dangerous and aggressive. They are prone to attack, and I've seen Romsai do this on one occasion to another elephant. The elephant sanctuary also has ducks, geese, buffaloes and cows. I rigged together a makeshift music centre with a CD Walkman, computer speakers, a motorbike battery and an inverter. A portable CD player would, of course, have been easier, but ours has seen better days. The ducks made me think of Saint-Saëns the Swan from The Carnival of the Animals. I don't play a recorder but plan to learn one day, as they are so easy to carry around, unlike other instruments I could mention. Perhaps something of the blowing down a tube is recognised by an elephant. My blind elephant friend Plara, who sadly passed away recently, used to like the recorder, I'm sure. A cat that's adopted us on our cabin balcony. By coincidence, it did actually start to settle down when I played the tune on the recorder. The Thai film crew headed back to Bangkok at twilight. We stayed on an extra day and I felt like playing some music by my American composer friend Douglas McCann. I thought Camoon would like to listen to his Cirque de Lune, even though it's still early morning. I took Moon to the reception to get his breakfast of fruit along with the other elephants. Walking with an elephant is a real treat. They are social animals, as we are, and make very good walking companions. Some surprising behaviour from John, the young elephant, and Songkran, the oldest, when the music started. Normally, Songkran pushes John away grumpily with her trunk whenever he gets too near, but today, with Alessandra Celletti's music, both seem to get on very well for a change. This unexpected friendly behaviour came as a big surprise to the mahouts watching at a distance. John likes showing his teeth, possibly hoping for a banana. Poor old Songkran next to him hasn't any teeth at all, which is why elephants don't survive at this age in the wild. They just can't eat. I tried playing a toy guitar to them both, just odd chords rather than music. This seemed to go down well with them both too. However, it wasn't picked up by the microphone, so be thankful for small blessings. Marley and Somboon are the best of best friends, both female. Both have had hard, stressful lives. They like to keep each other company at the sanctuary and spray themselves in dried mud to keep cool, especially Marley. I enjoy playing Dustin O'Halloran's music myself, being a country boy living in big hot Bangkok. It helps take me to a calm place, and I hoped his music would do the same for the elephants.